Low pressure, looooooser weather. So why does a low pressure system give us clouds and rain, what we refer to as looser weather, yet a high pressure system generally gives us clearer skies? Take a look at this diagram. Imagine that this line represents the ground. All right, so these are maybe different cities. They're not a neighborhood. This is a very large area covering many, many states. So there's the ground. We've got a low pressure and a high pressure system. You know that the air wants to move from high to low. So air moves from high pressure to low pressure. And now this is happening elsewhere as well. If there's the high pressure, the air is going to move this way, away from the high pressure. And the air is also going to move towards the low pressure on the other side. Well, what's all of this air going to do once it gets to the low pressure system? It's only got one place to go. It's not just going in towards the low pressure in our diagram from the sides, but imagine a three-dimensional model. All of the air's moving in towards that low pressure system. Let's take a look at what this would look like. Imagine all the air is going to be moving in towards the low. Right? So all remember the counterclockwise circulation? All that air is moving in towards the low. So it's only got one place to go, right? It can only go in one place, and that's up. So the air in a low pressure system tends to rise. So in a low pressure system, we have rising air. When air rises, it's going to expand. The pressure further up in the atmosphere is less. So as the air rises, it expands. And when air expands, it's going to cool. If you've ever let the air out of a tire, inside the tire, the air is under a lot of pressure. Yet when it comes out of the tire, it expands, it's under less pressure. It feels cooler. If you remember from the bottle activity where we pumped up the bottles and looked at how the temperature changed as the pressure changed. When the pressure was released, when the air expanded, the temperature dropped down. So in a low pressure system, air is rising and expanding. When it expands, it cools down. As the temperature gets closer to the dew point, the air becomes more saturated, and eventually that leads to the formation of clouds. So in a low pressure system, because the air is rising, that's where we have our formation of our clouds, which then could lead to rain. So in a low pressure system, air is rising. If we take a look at this, we can watch this. Air rises in a low pressure system, but if we look at this from the front, we see that it's not only moving into the low, but is rising up as well. And as that air rises, it expands, it cools, and we have condensation. So here we see in a low pressure system, air rises, it's going to cool, that's going to give us condensation. So low pressure So we have rise, expand, cools, condense. So it starts with the rising air. It's rising because it's got nowhere else to go. So air rises, it expands, cools, condenses. Condensation leads to clouds, which could potentially lead to a rain and stormy weather. So whenever we say low pressure, looser weather, that's the reason why low pressure air rises, expands, cools, condenses. We get all these clouds, we get all the rain at the low pressure. Now, in the high pressure, let's go back over to the high pressure. What's going on over here? If the air is rising in the low because that's where all the air is going to, well, in a high pressure, all the air is moving away from the high, right? In a high pressure system, all the air is going away from there. In a high pressure system, the air is going to descend. Instead of rising, it's going to fall to the earth in a high pressure system. So we see the circulation. We get our nice clockwise circulation in the high pressure system, and the air is going to descend into the high. And as it's descending, it's going to condense. Instead of it expanding, instead of having rise, expand, cool, condense, we're going to have the exact opposite of that. The air is going to descend down in the high pressure system. It's going to come from above and move downward. So instead of the air rising, the air falls. As the air sinks down, as the air falls from up or above, the pressure down at the Earth's surface is going to be more. So instead of expanding, the air is going to compress. As the air compresses, as we saw with the bottle activity, as we increased the pressure, that temperature got warmer. So the air warms. And if we increase the heat, as you guys learned from that evaporation, when you guys spilled the water on the table and evaporated the water as fast as you can, one of the best ways to get the water to evaporate more was to increase the heat. Many of you use the heat lamps in class. So the air warms, and when that happens, that increases the amount of evaporation. And I think I made a mistake here. It's not the air that condenses, it's the water vapor that condenses. So we have the water is going to evaporate, which leads to not clouds, but clear skies. So when we look at high pressure systems and low pressure systems, when we see that L, that big L on the map for low pressure, we know that that means looser weather's coming our way. We've got some clouds, some possible rain coming our way. When we say that high pressure, the skies are going to be a lot clearer. So low pressure air is rising, rise, expand, cool, condense. In the high pressure, the air is sinking, it's descending down. That's going to warm the air and lead to a lot of evaporation. Drier air is going to be around. These pressure systems help us predict, forecast what the weather's going to be like. Here's an example of a weather map from October of 2011. We see that the low pressure is up by the Great Lakes. There's a couple high pressures, one main one in Nebraska in the middle. And I'm going to superimpose on top of this the visible satellite image, and you can see where most of the clouds are. Look how the clouds are over that Great Lake region, right where that low pressure is. Very few clouds near that high pressure near Nebraska or even the one down in Texas. You can see where the clouds are. Those clouds are there because in the low pressure system, the air is rising, it's expanding, cooling, condensing. That's where we get our condensation. That's where we're going to get most of our clouds.